Okay, so we have another 101 OpenStudio tutorial. If you've been watching the previous ones, this 8-zone model will look familiar. We've changed some constructions and done our surface matching. And now what I'm going to discuss is searching. And there's a number of ways to search. To start with, I'm going to actually use a built-in OpenStudio or SketchUp tool, which is the outliner. So Susan is our scale figure that actually just came in with SketchUp, and we can actually select that and select that object in the model, and I'm going to delete that. So right now these zones aren't particularly meaningful in their name, but I can even here search for shading, and only the shading groups within surfaces will show, and then I can pick one of those and double-click it, and I can edit that. If I click this button here, I can show or hide the rest of the model. So that's a really powerful tool on its own. It doesn't look for individual surfaces, but it looks for zones or interior partition or shading surfaces. And again, once you start naming your zones, which is definitely a nice thing to do on a larger model, then that becomes even more powerful because you can search for zones possibly, let's say, on the west of the building. So I'm going to go and just quickly rename some of these. West 01, West 02. And you can only select one object at a time, and after I type something in this, I need to hit tab so that will actually get taken. If I don't hit tab, I'll show you what happens. West 04, and I'm just going to go somewhere else now, and I go back to West 04 and it never changed. So I type what I want, and now my zone names will reflect here. And so now if I type in west, it should not be case sensitive. All of my west zones will show up. So that's where naming zones or partition groups becomes really meaningful to do. So what if I want to search for individual surfaces? That's where our surface searching tool comes in handy. So if I click here, I can search by name. But I can also search by class or by type. And sometimes if I pick a particular class like building surface detailed, then I can pick boundary conditions and only have objects that have a surface boundary condition. So if I search the entire model, again, I can just search a selection or the entire model. It will hide everything except in surface boundary conditions. So what I basically did is I hid my ground, anything with a ground condition, I hid all the exterior ones. And so now I have the interior surfaces that are heat transfer surfaces. The reason you see the color changing here is I have the floor of one zone up against the roof of another zone. If I switch to my zone outside boundary condition rendering mode, then these show up as green, and these would be green if I didn't have the air boundary condition set, but that rendering mode kind of overrides whatever rendering mode I'm in. So another thing I could do, and sometimes you hide so much of the model that you can't really tell where you are. So that's where this show hidden geometry button comes in. It lets me quickly see the rest of the model and then hide it. And where that would be more meaningful, let me go back. When you're done, you go to unhide all. I'm going to look at the name of this surface, which I'll admit is probably going to be something really obscure. And I'm just going to say Southwest Roof, and I'll name that. So you might have run a simulation and you came up with an error in Energy Plus that a certain surface didn't have the area that was expected, or something was wrong. Maybe it had a invalid construction. So you may not know where that is in the model, particularly if you didn't make the model. So if you know the name of the surface, you can just type in Southwest. I think it'll take a partial name here. So this is where unhiding the rest of the model is more meaningful, because I don't know where this is in the project, and I can quickly see it here and change it. And by the way, once I have a selection made by using a search, I can then go into default constructions and I can change my roof. I don't know if we have any roofs that we imported, but let's just pick something inappropriate that we'll just show as the example and do some insulated concrete forms. And I'm going to apply that just to the selection. So what will happen here if I unhide the rest of my model is, well, this roof got a new construction. If I go to another zone that was not selected at the time, this roof did not get a new construction, and it just has the basic exterior roof. So I'd say diagnostics and applying constructions are probably the most typical uses for when you'd want to search. But users will always come up with more reasons that they want to do that. So that's the basics of searching. Really, really important on large models to save a lot of time. And next we will pick up with zone loads, which will start to add internal loads into your building so that when it'll make the simulation results more meaningful.